I want to explain this a little bit more detail. So let's do this. If you look at the timeline for a particular processor PGA, it might look like this, that TI was running here, got descheduled, and then there were a couple of other threads that ran on PGA, TX and TY. So now if I want to think about the affinity for TI with respect to this processor PGA, that affinity, if we're going to schedule TI now on PGA, the affinity number that I want to compute for this guy is 2, indicating the number of intervening threads that ran on PJ between the last time TI ran on it and if I schedule TI now at this point of time. And so clearly, this number that I'm talking about, the affinity number, the smaller the number, the higher the affinity. So when we say the affinity number is 2, it means there are 2 intervening threads that ran on PJ between the time TI got dibs on PJ now at this point of time and at this point of time. Okay, that's the idea behind this affinity index. So what we want to do is, in the minimum intervening scheduling policy, you want to keep this information about the affinity for TI to run on every processor. If I have a multiprocessor with 16 processors, then there is an affinity index associated with every one of those processors for TI. It might be that on processor 1, TI has an affinity index of 2. On processor 2, it has an affinity index of 4, and so on and so forth. And what we want to do is, when it comes time to scheduling TI, I want to pick a processor on which the affinity index is the minimum. So the minimum affinity index indicates that there was a minimum number of intervening threads on that particular processor. That's the processor on which I want to run TI. That is amplifying the chance that TI is going to find its memory contents, the working set, in the caches. That's the idea behind minimum intervening scheduling policy.